Therefore, it is essential to first understand the, what this theory is all about. See, we know now that they discovered this connection between North Indian languages and European languages and they made up this theory. But what exactly are the basic postulates of this theory? There are four basic postulates of this theory. You have to understand what they are. The first is that the languages of Northern India, Iran, Central Asia and Europe are related to each other as members of a language family, which is called Aryan or Indo-European. This is the first postulate of the theory. This family has been named Aryan or Indo-European as distinct from other language families like Dravidian, Semito-Hamitic, Austric, Sino-Tibetan, etc. Second postulate is that all these languages, since they are related to each other, they must have descended from a common ancestor, like we say Marathi, Hindi, etc. came from Sanskrit. So like that, all these languages which are related to each other must have come from some ancestral form. Now that ancestral form is not recorded anywhere, but the linguists, by linguistic reconstruction, they compared all the existing Aryan languages of India and Europe and other places, and they reconstructed, artificially reconstructed this language, which is called Proto-Indo-European. And they decided that all these languages are descended from that Proto-Indo-European language. That is the second postulate. The third postulate is, this ancestral language must have been spoken in one particular place, because the Aryan languages are spread out from Sri Lanka to the south of India. Because the South Indian languages are not Aryan, they are Dravidian languages. But to the south of India, the language of Sri Lanka, Sinhalese, is an Aryan language. So right from Sri Lanka to Scandinavia and Britain, the Aryan languages are spoken. So it cannot be possible that the original Proto-Indo-European language was also spoken all over this area. It must have been spoken in one particular area and then it spread everywhere. So that particular area is the Proto-Indo-European homeland. This is the third postulate. And finally, we have the fourth postulate, that this Proto-Indo-European homeland must have been in some central area between Sri Lanka and Scandinavia, and that is in South Russia and not in India. If it is not in India, that means the Rig Veda and the Vedic culture has come from outside, from South Russia. So it was brought into India from outside by Aryan invaders or immigrants. So this is the Aryan invasion theory. Now it must be remembered that according to this theory, even the Britishers are not native to Britain. They also went from South Russia. The Germans are also not native to Germany. But nowhere in those countries do they talk of an Aryan invasion of Britain by the ancestors of the British people, of the English people. It is only in India that this theory has been made into a political issue.